the next thing I've done, so that's all the packages that have got dependencies on several other optional packages done, apart from Polkit, which is waiting for Plasma now. So I've got three packages that I'm not going to build now because they're waiting for Plasma or KDE or both. And I've got five more packages, which are the ones you can see in the browser now that is highlighted. So I've got Object Introspection. These all depend on one another. I've got a rebuild for QT. It needs to be built before KDE, which I'll be doing sometime. And there's probably other dependencies that's got now that it didn't have previously. QT Web Engine needs to be reinstalled because we're reinstalling QT. I thought that'd be a good idea to do that. Plus we've got extra libraries built now that we didn't have before. In fact, there's one there, an extra one that needs to be installed by the looks of it. And then that enables Cairo to be built, which had a dependency on QT itself as well there, which wouldn't have been available when we first built Cairo. And then libdrm and gobject have both got dependencies on Cairo. So that's why these five are outstanding. So QT, if you remember, QT took about 45, 50 minutes, and QT Web Engine was approximately an hour, hour and 10 minutes. So these are going to be a little bit of time. But it's worth doing just to make sure everything's in place and correct. So the first thing I need to do is to expand the package for QT. Now, of course, because it's already installed, there's certain things we won't need to do. For example, one of them is that we won't need to do this because that directory is in place and the link's in place. But this QT5 prefix, it exists purely for the build. Not sure if it's set unset anywhere. Probably not, but it's not a permanent prefix. It's just here for building. Because the basic reason why it's not permanent is because it gets built into the config files here. So I've been through these, we've got all these options installed now. There's no reason for anything to stop us rebuilding this. So that's installed, it's going to QT everywhere. One of the thing is this takes up 15 gigabytes, we've got 16 gig free. So it's going to be a bit tight, but it should build without any problems. It says about this QCO, I looked at that, QCO depends directly on QT5, and it says if you reinstall QT5, you've got to reinstall QCA. So because we haven't got QCA at the moment, we don't need to install that or reinstall it. Also, this warning says about if you're reinstalling QT5 into the same place that you're going to override the existing libraries that may be in use by a window manager that's using QT5, well, TWM, we built way before QT5, so that's not a problem. And we don't need to worry about this because we've got all the recommended dependencies. So I'm going to run this sed command in first, and then prepare this configure command, and just have a look at the options listed. So confirm licenses there, open source install. That's to prevent the examples from being built. We haven't really got the space for it now and probably don't want them. It's just going to make the build even longer. System SQLite, we've got dbus linked and open SSL linked. Don't want the QT Web Engine, and we do want the system half buzz. So looks like that's probably the configure that we want. So let's just give a quick look at the summary. There's lots of yeses there, so that's good. Let's have a look, see what it isn't doing. Is probably quicker. See if there's anything there that it's not going to use or install that we expected to use. Oh, looks good. So you can see which databases it's using there. Yeah, it looks like it's using everything. There's nothing there that I didn't expect to have a no against. So we can go ahead and build this. Okay, so that has built. Let's make install now. As the root. Okay, it's also an intrinsic command, by the looks of it. Okay, so that's installed. Now I've got to remove these files that relate to the install directory. So let's remove them. And then we've got to become the root user and put all this in. So let's just see what QT5 does. QT5 prefix / bin, right, okay. And the QT5 prefix is there. Oh yes, that's what was created at the top. Be sure that the QT5 bin dev variable is defined in root's environment where it's going to be created here, so we can just become the proper root, I think. I think that should be sure that the QT5 prefix variable is defined in the root's environment. So we've got to be careful here that we retain that. So if I do sudo -su, you see the QT5 is there still. So that's good. So I'm going to, although this is not necessary, I'm going to do these install commands. Some may fail. No, they've worked anyway. I thought the install create might fail. Now these ones, these should already exist, and these are appending this information to the file. So all I'm going to do is just check that information is still actually in these files. Right, it's actually overwritten them with new files. So I do need to copy all of this. Probably need to check these links. I imagine they're still there. Although they're forcing the links, so it wouldn't matter to run them anyway. But let's take a look. QT5. Oh, that QT5 binder didn't run. That's interesting. Didn't I do that? Right, that, I'm going to have to remove these. I obviously didn't run that bit. Let's just take a look at this. Oops. Yeah, and if I do this again, imagine that's appending it. Oh no, it is overwriting it. Oh yeah, so of course it's only one chevron there. So I should be able to do all of these again. So I'm just going to check each one of these. Make sure they've got the right path. Don't want to break things now that are working. So OptQT 5 bin assistant. So that's right. And in fact, I should be able to do slash user slash share applications. Design a QT 5 web, QT 5 desktop. Is that one? Yeah. Linguist. What's that one? And the last one is QD bus viewer. QD bus viewer. Yeah, so they're okay. Yeah, so this one about the QT5 suffix, if I look at these, so the first one's in mock, that's minus L, so mock's a program, user bin file dash QT5, right, okay, so user bin. So I should find something called mock-qt5, yes it is there. And so if I do star-qt5, so we've got mock is there, mock-qt5, UIC is there, RCC, QMake, L-convert, L-release, and L-update. So they're all done, so I'm not even bothered running that again. Let's just check this exists. It should already exist. Shouldn't need to edit this at all. Just check that's the same. Oh, this is for the user. Yes, I'm trying to skip through this too quick. Check this one still there. Of course, this shouldn't have got touched at all. No, that's okay. So, yeah, the LDSO config should look like this one at the bottom or somewhere near the bottom. So, there it is there. OptQT5 qlib, QT5 lib. And it says to run ldconfig, which makes sense to load the new libraries. There was a little pause there as it loaded them. And then this profile needs to be loaded as well. So this is different from this one up here because we've installed it in the opt directory. So QT5 dir equals opt path append. Yep, that looks fine. And what I'm going to do while I'm here is just run that remove LA files as well, in case this causes any problems now that we've got more stuff installed and a bigger package installed just now and one to install. So that should be QT5 reinstalled. So I remove that source. I should look to see how much space was left actually, never mind. So I'm going to mark that as complete on my rebuild. So yes, that has been rebuilt before KDE. So now I'm going to do QT Web Engine because that's after QT. So I'll get rid of that one. just check this. Else lib pulse audio. So we need this one. Opus, I think I've done that one. Let's just check Opus. Lib Opus. Yep. So it's just this Ginger module. Let's look at the Python. No, it's not there. So let's go into Python. It needs markup safe, and that's already been installed by the looks of it, so we can just download this. And move it from the BLFS directory into the Python directory and extract it. So it says both the Python 2 and Python 3 can be built without any conflict. So although QT Web Engine only needs Python 2, I'm going to build both of them. And it looks like we just do one command. That's the root. That's the Python 2. It looks like it's exactly the same for Python 3, except for the Python executable. Yep. And that's done. So back to the BLFS directory. Close that one down, and now we can extract QT Web Engine. So this only uses 3.6 gigs, so that's okay. I do vaguely remember there was some issues here, was there? Was it the tests that were failing? Oh no, there's no test suite. Maybe I'm thinking of something else. Okay, so that's extracted. So we need to do some changes. If an older version of the package's main library has been installed, when the package is built separately, it will link to that in preference to its own not yet installed version and fail because the missing symbols prevent that. I'm going to run this anyway, so that it does link against the ones we're building, in case that causes a problem. As root, sudo su, echo $qt5, dir should exist, it does. Worth checking that. Okay, so now we can build the package. Let's create the build directory first and then concentrate on any extra options. Now, I seem to remember that we had to do something with the jobs here. Let's try it as it is, because we have got a full installation now, which is what we didn't have before. Let's check, see what's come up. There's not so many So much information reported here. So it's not going to use a system ninja. I think that's what it's saying here at the top. Too snappy except I can't see anything there that looks out of the ordinary, so I'm just going to start the build and keep an eye on it for a short while in case it does abort straight away. Let's time it. Okay, so that's finished building, just under 2 hours. So there's no test suite, so we'll just install it. And we've just got to run this command here to find some files and delete them that are not needed. That should be it for QT Web Engine. So I'm going to mark that off my rebuild list as built. And save it. And then get rid of that web page, sorry, that tab, and tidy up. So it should be about, yeah, we've still got 16 gig space, there shouldn't have been any more disk space taken up.